Confused about the cosmos? Can't tell a planet from a star? Then give us just 5 minutes and we'll show you what they are. Jack Horkheimer, Stargazer, tells you all about the night sky and the biggest show of all, the universe. And now, this week's episode.
Jupiter and the brightest star in the night sky. Hey there, stargazers. I'm Ed Romano, amateur astronomer from Rhode Island, and I'll be your guest host this month on Stargazer. Although there are many bright objects in the heavens in early evening, three of the brightest are there for you to enjoy right now. One of them holds the distinction of being the brightest star visible from Earth, other than our sun, and the other is the biggest and almost the brightest planet in our solar system. And of course, you know all about the moon. Let me show you. Okay. We've got our sky set up for an hour after sunset, this week and next. Facing west, shining brilliantly not far above the horizon, is the biggest of all the planets, Jupiter, which will set about an hour after the sun. So get out early to catch it. Then turn and look to the southeast, where you'll see the brightest constellation of them all, Orion the Hunter. Two bright stars mark his shoulders, two bright stars mark his knees, and three not quite as bright stars, equally spaced in a row, mark his belt. And if you shoot an imaginary arrow through Orion's belt, down to his left, you will see a dazzling star, which literally outshines all the stars in the heavens as seen from the Earth. The star Sirius, which marks the nose of Orion's faithful companion, Canis Major, the great dog. In fact, we can make a very nice stick figure of a dog by drawing lines between Canis Major's stars with Sirius marking his nose. Now, although Sirius is nicknamed the dog star, I personally prefer the name that the ancient Egyptians gave it, the Soul of Isis. But whatever name it has enjoyed for the past several thousand years, it is still the brightest and most jewel-like star we can see. But there's a catch here, because even though Sirius is the brightest star we can see with the naked eye, it is not actually the brightest. It only appears to be the brightest because it is so close to us. In fact, it is the fifth closest star to planet Earth, not quite 9 light-years away. And although it's nearby cosmically speaking, it's still over 500,000 times farther away from us than our closest star, the Sun. And we can see many stars, which are hundreds of times larger than Sirius, like Orion's red shoulder star, Betelgeuse. Even so, Sirius makes our own star, the Sun, look rather puny by comparison, because while our Sun is almost 1 million miles in diameter, Sirius is almost twice as wide. And while our Sun burns at a relatively cool 10,000 degrees Fahrenheit at its surface, Sirius blazes a fierce 17,000 degrees Fahrenheit, which makes it shine 25 times brighter than our Sun. Wow! Thank heavens it isn't as close to us as our Sun, or we'd all have to wear sunglasses to get to sleep at night. At any rate, if you watch Sirius when it is close to the horizon, it will look even more dazzling than when it's up high. In fact, it will flash and sparkle and change brilliant colors like a cosmic jewel, unlike any other star in the heavens. So get thee outside to see Jupiter in the west after sunset, and then turn to the southeast and enjoy Sirius, the dog star, and the ancient soul of Isis. It will dazzle you. I'm Ed Romano. Keep looking up.
Make the Stars Your Own is available on DVD or VHS for $19.95. In addition, Stargazing with Jack Horkheimer, Cosmic Comics for the Sky Watcher, is also available for $19.95.
Thank you.